My name is Justin Schwartz. I'm an engineer at Universal Orlando Resort. I've worked on many different attractions at Universal, from roller coasters to motion simulators.
We're gonna board the Hogwarts Express.
They even train. Today we're gonna learn a lot about the Hollywood Rip Ride Rockit roller coaster and the physics and science behind it. The steps for designing a roller coaster at Universal require a very specific engineering design process. First thing we do is we come up with the creative intent, and for Rockit, we knew we wanted to build a roller coaster that involved music and audio. We did that by adding onboard audio, onboard lighting, and onboard video onto the ride itself so we can capture the guest's total experience. And the design phase, we use computer programs that actually show exactly the forces and the dynamics on the ride themselves. When we design the elevations and turns on a roller coaster, we have to use Newton's laws of motion and kinetic energy and potential energy. When we lift a ride to the top of the hill, we're actually adding potential energy into the ride. And when the ride goes over the top of the hill, it changes that potential energy into kinetic energy. Throughout that entire time, Newton's laws of motion are in effect. And Newton's first law of motion indicates that an object at rest will stay at rest unless an outside force is applied to it. When we lift the vehicle to the top of the hill, we're actually adding energy into it, which is Newton's first law of motion. Also, Newton's second law of motion, which is force equals mass times acceleration. On a roller coaster, when we bring that vehicle to the top of the hill with a chain, we're actually accelerating that vehicle, and there's forces attached to that chain when we accelerate the vehicle up to the top of the hill. Newton's third law of motion is really important when designing roller coasters. Newton's third law of motion says for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. So that applies to a roller coaster between the ride vehicles and the track. When a ride goes up and down the hill, it creates different forces onto the track. Those forces into the track get transmitted into the columns and into the foundations and into the ground. But also, those forces get reapplied back into the vehicle through the polyurethane wheels and into the axle, into the steel frame of the vehicle itself. The Hollywood Rip Ride Rockit goes through many different alterations and refinements. When we first come up with the course design, we're not exactly sure what the forces are going to be on the ride until we go through all the science and math required to figure that out. Then we go back and we redesign the vehicle to really match what those design requirements are, such that it can go through that maneuver and deliver the great experience that we deliver today. I knew when I went to my first theme park that I wanted to design and build roller coasters. I thought to myself, how do I get involved in an industry like this? And I talked to my teachers and friends and family, and they told me that engineering is really a great path forward to get into designing roller coasters. I've always been interested in things that move and the science behind it.